If you are trying to get more people to visit your website so you can grow your business or your brand, this is the video for you. I'm going to show you two ways of how you can add meta tags and meta descriptions to your WordPress website. If this is your first time to the website, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and then hit the bell for notifications. I post weekly videos on how you can grow your business by doing better marketing. Okay, adding meta tags is great, but it's more important to understand why you want to add meta tags. You don't need to add all of them, even though that could be helpful, but if you add the correct ones, which is what I'm going to go over in this video, you're going to be in a better spot instead of trying to understand everything you can. So first off, let's just go through some search results, because adding these tags are a great way for search engines to understand your website. So first, let me show you what we're looking at, and then I'll show you why, and then I'll show you how. So what you can see here, let's turn on my little pen. We have some things that are going on. We have this text, which looks different. Then we also have some text down here that is giving us further description. The best way to understand this is that this right here is our URL. What that means, that's the link that if someone goes and clicks on this information in this box, what they're gonna do is then they're gonna go to a specific URL. That's the link that you give. So remember that URL. The next thing that we have here is your page title. This page title is a great way for people to understand what information they're going to read. So it's a really big headline. The best way to think of it is like a newspaper article. You want it to be thought-provoking and in a way gets them to the next point, which is to click it and then go to your website. So it's important to think of a title. You're not just writing it whatever you want it to be, but it really needs to be informative to get your ideal person to click on that. The next thing that we have here is all of the text that's happening here. And this is the description. This description is telling a little bit more about the title. And if you've written the description right and the title right, you'll see that sometimes Google and other search engines like Bing or Yahoo will give bold to those descriptive words. So it's important to do that because the person that's looking for you and your business is going to be using Google this way. Now, just to show that I'm not making all this up, there's a lot of different marketing information out there. You can always go to Google itself. You could just go to support.google.com and you can put in /webmaster and it'll give you all the information on what Google recommends that you do for search engine optimization. And that's the key. You want your website to go high in Google. And in order to do that, we want to put certain tags on your page and on your website so people can find you. The best way to understand it is what Google says right about here, meta tags. They say a meta tag gives Google and other search engines a summary of what the page is about. So Google is a robot. It has an algorithm. It's just going out there searching multiple websites. And then what it does is once it finds a website, it takes the title, it takes the URL, and it takes that description that I just showed you, and then it puts that in the search results. So your customer, that's what they're looking for. So let's go ahead and jump in and figure out how to do that. I'm gonna give you two different ways to do it if you're using the Gutenberg editor on your WordPress website. I'll show you what that looks like, and then I'll show you what it looks like if you're using Divi. There's a link to this in the description of this video. I use Divi for my websites, but not everyone uses Divi. If you're interested in a course, you can click on that link and learn more. But I'll show you both ways just in case you're not using it. So let's start here with first adding a plugin. This is something we've gone over before, but if you haven't seen those previous videos, the first thing that you want to do to add is we want to add a plugin called Yoast. So once you log into your WordPress website, go to plugins, you can go up here. It's not there, but we want to type in Yoast. It's Y-O-A-S-T. And then you press enter. Once you press enter, it's going to come back with tons of results. Now you can see here that I already have it active, but if you haven't installed this, it'll show this text. It'll say install now. You click install now. The next thing it'll do is after it installs, it asks if you want to activate it. Once you activate it, it's good to go and it'll be grayed out like mine, and it'll just let you know this is active. So once you've done that, now we're ready to go and start adding meta tags, which for the rest of this video, I might just say page titles and descriptions, just so that we understand we're really trying to do this to get your website to show higher and that Google and other search engines know what they're looking for. So I won't go through all the basics of SEO, but just enough that if you've written good content, how you can get it to show up higher. So number one, make sure this Yoast is installed. I've already created a page here and I've added a title. Let's just go ahead and update this. Thank you so much, Grammarly. Thank you. So now that I have this page, this once again is the Gutenberg editor. Now, this is not as easy to make sense of, but this is what we have if you're not using a different type of editor. So this right here is my page title. And I just stole this from somewhere because I didn't want to write it, but I wanted to show you. So this right here is my page title. So if we were looking at a Google result, it would say this, meta tags for SEO WordPress. And as you can see here, meta tags for SEO WordPress. And if I type in website, you'll see here that that title now will change. And this is what it would look like in WordPress, meta tags for SEO WordPress website. And that's important that you have Yoast, because if you have Yoast, it's this little, and I'll show you, let me expand. This is what it looks like here. It's not the easiest to look at in Gutenberg, but if you're using it, I want you to know how to use it. I don't use it, but nevertheless, some of you maybe. If you're using it, you can collapse and expand just by clicking that. But this is the plugin that we just added. You don't have to do anything else. After you activate it, it's now available for you to use on a blog post or on a blog page. So whatever page title I gave is going to be right here. And then sometimes it will go ahead and take information here. But I love that they leave this blank because once they leave it blank, it really just prompts you to come down here and write some sentences. So what you can do is actually massage the text that you have here. So I've deleted everything. And let's just say I wanted my title to be specific and I want it to be something like how to add meta tags to your website. So you can see here that as I'm typing, it's showing that orange bar and it's growing as I continue typing. And it's showing me that there could be a good range. So let's go back to Google just for 1 second. So you can see here, oops, there it is. You can see that there's different lengths of titles that we have here. And then if the title is actually too long, it'll give you this ellipsis right here. So what that bar is trying to do is make sure that whatever I type doesn't get to the point to where it's truncated. So if we go back here to the post, I can keep typing. Let's just put some other information here, Joseph Bojang. So that right there looks good. It's green. I would just go with it. Here, now I can write the meta description. So this is the title. It's the blue. Once again, the title is right here, what I have highlighted. Now, if we want to write a different description, this is just some text to blah. I'm just going to add some stuff here because I don't want to keep writing, but I want to get rid of the orange, and I recommend you do it too. Not getting into the SEO, but just kind of showing you the idea. So once I have everything added, we can see an idea of what I have. I have my title, I have my page description, and now let's look at my URL. Now, the thing about a URL, in this view, it doesn't easily show you. You actually have to, if you're using Gutenberg, you have to go to document, and then you have to go down here to permalink, and this shows you what is going to be used for the website. So if I click permalink and I click on that, oops, that is the wrong one. Let's actually, there it is right here. So this is the permalink that what it would use. So my website would use meta tags for SEO WordPress website. So that's what would be in the search engine along with the title and the meta description that I just added. When you add that, it allows Google to know more about your website, more about that page, or more about that blog post. It's very important to put that in there. You could also add other types of tags to images and things like that, but that's more of an alternative tag, not so much a meta tag. If you do what I just did, more than likely, that's all you need to do. For 90% of the people that post and do anything on the web, that's all you need to do. I'm going to show you the same thing, but just in a different view. So on my website and most of the websites that I use, I'm using Divi, which is what I use in my course. So you can see here that I can actually build this website in a different way, but everything is just easier to see. I can see the permalink, which is the name of the URL that I'll use. When I was looking over here, I had to look for it. And if it's on the wrong tab, or if this is closed, it's just not as easy to find everything. And you just have to know what a permalink is. A permalink is not something that we just say in every day. We usually just say, we want to get the URL. So it just makes it a little bit different to use. Even though this says permalink right here, it's so easy to see that you kind of know what it's going to do. We also have the title. It's just set off differently. We know that this title is the title of the page. The content is laid out differently, but like before, you still have Yoast with the same type of functionality, and I can collapse it or expand it the same way. I could come in here and erase this like I did before, so I can actually start writing whatever I want, and I can write the meta description here just as easy. One thing that I think is important to think about until I record the video on SEO, but as you write this information and as you start giving a particular keyword or keyword phrase, so let's just say I do meta tags, what's going to happen is that this plugin will start telling you how good you are doing for SEO. So you could play around with that. But in this video, I just wanted to give you some quick information how to add, I believe, the most important meta tags to your website. There's many more you could add, but if you just do what I did, you'll be fine in getting your website to rank higher in the Google search engine or any search engine that you plan to have customers find you. Well, that's it for today. I would love to know, what else would you like to know about getting your website or blog post ranked higher in a search engine, whether it's Google or any other search engine out there? I would love to know what you would like to know next. Thank you so much for listening. Until next time, have a great week.